Blackhawks are changing on the fly. Frolik with a shot and a good save by Luongo. Just 10 seconds in, so he's into it already. Out to center, Hansen had to hold up. It's a turnover. Here comes Dave Bolin, stopped at the line by Hamhuis. Up the middle goes Ben Smith, the hero of game six, who scored the winner in overtime. Now he's chasing. Here comes Kessler to the net. Centering pass, score!
Alexander Burrows came into this series in game six with a big night. And it's Ryan Kessler, who still has yet to score in this series, who does all the handiwork. A turnover, a nice power move towards the net on Duncan Keith, and then sold it to everyone. The backhand looked like it was going to go to the net. Look at how he sells it for a split second. Knew exactly where Burrows was.
Chicago was trying desperately to change and couldn't quite get it finished.
The early energy here has been supplied by a bunch of hits, and here's another one for Rafi Torres, who's been the lightning rod of this series. And this is a page out of first period of game one. Just finish your checks, the defense jumping up and being aggressive. You can see Alberts was all the way down past the goal line. Rafi Torres always playing on that edge, and that's given not only the team a little bit of life and settled everybody in, Jim, it's given the crowd that energy as well.
Winger win from Hossa. He takes a shot that hit a leg. Ben Smith shoots it. Luongo made the save and hangs off. Pisani. Marcus Kruger centering. Johnson's shot stopped by Luongo. Patrick Kane to the net. Luongo to save. Loose puck. Taves stopped by Luongo. Still loose. And Roberto Luongo reaches out and grabs the puck. Victor Stahlberg hit hard by Kessler. Campbell knew he was going to get hit. Moved the puck in a hurry. Hossa holds the puck in. Stahlberg shoots. That's blocked in front by Dan Hamhuis.
I think they're feeling like he's getting his stride and getting his confidence.
Another big hit by Kessler and a shot wide of the net. He got Chalmerson this time. Chalmerson to Campoli. He's hit hard by Rafi Torres. Seabrook to Patrick Kane. Back in come the Hawks. Chip and chase for Kane. Slipped the check, then got run over, but he knew it was coming and went down. Ryan Campbell, first man back, Burrows on him. Pierre comes in and crunches Duncan Keith. He's ready to center. His pass to Sharp. By Edler and knocked down. Here comes Brian Campbell. Turns back, feeds the point. Keith with a shot, deflected twice. Stopped by Luongo. Patrick Sharp to Patrick Kane. He gets plastered by Bieksa. Higgins checked by Campoli. Lapierre to the slot. Hansen kicked it back. Ballard to Yannick Hansen. Keith Ballard. Edler shoots it. That's blocked. Edler again. Over to Keith Ballard to the net. Crawford with the save. Jarred loose. Chris Higgins. Alexander Edler. Big war in front. There's a shot tipped by Lapierre. Shot over top of the net by Yannick Hansen. Higgins, Lapierre, and Hansen putting the pressure on. Higgins again. Lapierre to Hansen. He was checked. Ballard to Alexander Edler with a shot tipped by Lapierre. After the puck is Marian Hossa. The Hawks are under siege. Edler holds the puck in. Yannick Hansen. Ballard shoots. Great save by Crawford. Ballard again. Chris Higgins for Yannick Hansen. Canucks are changing. Hansen slap pass tipped wide by Henrik Sedin. Here comes Hansen again from Henrik Sedin. Back to Henrik out of his reach. Keith Ballard to the net, tipped and tipped into the corner. Blackhawks are dog tired. Henrik to the net. Seabrook gets a hold of the puck on a tip. Thrown out to center. Patrick Sharp must be dead tired. Puts the puck on net. Luongo stops play. What pressure by Vancouver. Hard centering pass comes all the way back. Keith is in trouble. Here comes Alex Burrows. Trying to break away. Pulled down. Penalty shot. Penalty shot for Alex Burrows. Here he goes. Stopped by Crawford. Kessler, Raymond, and Burrows have come back on for Vancouver. There's a hard hit at center. Ballard with a hip check, and he got Kruger hard. Jonathan Taves to Patrick Sharp. Wide on Bieksa. Cut off by Edler. Michael Frolik. Big hit on Frolik by Alexander Edler. Kruger helps out. Sharp with a shot. Rebound. Loose side of the net. Kicked out by Luongo. He got his and made a goal line stand that keeps this at 1-0.
At a time where the entire crowd is holding its breath. Look at on the doorstep, Luongo sensed where the puck was going to his left and got enough of his body there. Tracked it across all the way down, and then the last second was able to get some help from Erhoff as well, who just pinned Kruger to the net.
Kane shoots! Robbery by Roberto! Kosa out of the corner. There's a great save by Luongo and a shot by Frolik. Bobbled it, stopped it, and smothered it.
Do whatever you have to stop the puck, and that's exactly what this sequence was for Roberto Luongo. A high snapshot. He couldn't get his glove on it, got his neck instead, and then another quick shot. We've seen a couple of bobbles, but nobody in front. Great box out by Erhoff on one side. No chance for Boland to get to that loose puck.
Taves down low, looking in front. Now he makes a pass. Sharp, great save by Luongo on Patrick Sharp.
A nifty pass across. Look at the reaction of Luongo. Gets across, gets the blocker in position, and Sharp trying to deal with a rolling puck. Couldn't get it far enough in the corner.
Ryan Johnson just gets it out. And he stumped the puck back in. Campoli trying to clear it. Burrows shoots, scores!
And Ryan Johnson is on the ice because of the second centerman. A rolling puck. You mentioned all the time that Burrows had to think about that penalty shot. This time he just reacts. He's got a rolling puck, and instead of trying to settle it down, he just buries his head and hammers it and then gets buried by emotions of his teammates. And for Campoli, under pressure, can't get it there. Great read and reaction. And a wise move. There's no way you're going to be able to settle that down and get a shot. Burrows buries it and buries a lot of bad memories for the Vancouver Canucks.
So much on the line tonight for everyone in the Vancouver organization. The President's Trophy winners finally finished off the Stanley Cup champs. Exhale, British Columbia. The Canucks are on to round two. Nashville is next. Scott Oak and Roberto Luongo.
Roberto, it's quite likely that in your career as a Vancouver Canuck, you've never faced as much pressure as you did tonight. Just tell me how you're feeling.
Unbelievable. Probably better than the gold medal game right now. I mean, there was a lot of pressure, and I'm just glad that as a team we played a solid game, and even then they tied it, we stayed with it.
You did not beat just any team in the first round of the playoffs here. You beat the Stanley Cup champions. You beat the team that took you out in each of the last 2 years. You beat the team that seemed able to score on you like no other team in the Stanley Cup playoffs. Does it make it that much sweeter?
Yeah, it does. I mean, it's huge. It's really big. I can't really put it into words right now, but you know what? That's just the first round. We got a long way to go.
All right, you faced some adversity in the first round, and clearly games 4, 5, and 6 was that for the Vancouver Canucks. What do you think you learned from it that'll help you to go on in this tournament?
Well, every game's important, you know, whether we're up or down in the series. We can't take any games off, and we saw what happened. They came back, and they brought it all the way to the end.
Thanks a lot, Roberto. Here's Kevin Bieksa. Kevin, you guys faced almost ridiculous pressure in this game. The BC Lower Mainland was on the edge of its seat. I know you had to be in the moment and focus on the game, but you couldn't be oblivious to the mood around town. How did you read it?
Well, I think it was exciting. It was a lot of fun. As you can see, the people are very passionate here, and I don't think I've ever heard of burning a building that loud when we scored that last goal.
What worked for you tonight that didn't in the previous three?
I don't know. We were resilient. We scored a couple big goals. Played well as a team. We battled. Did everything we could to win.
Do you think Ryan Kessler played as determined tonight as he ever has as a Canuck?
Yeah, I think so. I think we had a lot of great efforts tonight. He obviously led the charge, and well, what a great feeling right now.
How much do you think Alexander Burrow's goal is going to mean to this franchise?
Well, I got the puck right here, so it's going on eBay tomorrow.
He's not getting it?
It was a big one. I'm going to go present it to him right now. It's a big one.
Right, here he comes. You can give it to him. We'll get a word with him. Get Alexander over here. And the puck presentation from Kevin Bieksa. I just asked Kevin this question, but of course it's better put to you. Do you have any idea what that winning goal means to this franchise?
Oh, it's just happy that the guys could kill my pal here early in OT. They did a great job. They made a big save, and just lucky enough to get a bounce and get a shot on net, and luckily went in.
You had a spectacular night, Alexander. You opened the scoring. You had a penalty shot in the second period. You get the OT winner. Is this the game of your life?
One of the biggest goal of my life, that's for sure. Obviously, we didn't make it easy on ourselves, but we worked hard for more than 60 minutes, and team effort again tonight, and we're looking forward to the second round.
Thanks, Alexander. Appreciate your time. Ryan Kessler, I asked Kevin Bieksa this of you, so I'll ask you. You had a look on your face to start this game like we've never seen before. Is this as determined as you've ever played?
Yeah. I've never wanted something as bad as I wanted this game. And, you know, everybody in that room wanted it just as bad as I did. And we played for each other in that room. And, you know, we really care about each other. And that's what it's all about.
What were you thinking, Ryan, after the Chicago Blackhawks won games 4, 5, and 6 and you were on the ropes?
You know what? Obviously, when you're up 3-0, you don't expect to play a game 7, but that's the way it happened. We didn't worry about the past. We focused on this game, and I think we played our best game of the series.
You didn't score in this series, but you did a magnificent job against the Jonathan Toews line. He finally got the shorthanded goal late in the game to send it to OT. But what did you make of your work against the Hawks captain?
You know what? He's a great player, and I have a lot of respect for him. It's tough keeping him off the board, but I pride myself on that part of the game. And yeah, I didn't score, but I kept him off the scoreboard for most of the games.
Final quick question here, Ryan. There was no end of pressure on this team coming into this game. How could you be oblivious to it?
What's that?
How could you be oblivious to the pressure this team was facing coming into this game? Or could you?
You know, we're used to the kind of media pressure, and we're a close-knit group. So, we dealt with it. It's something we played for our whole lives. We're game 7 overtime. We came out and we wanted to take this game, and we did.
Where are you going tonight?
We're going to celebrate tonight and move on.
All right, thanks, Ryan.
The Crown Royal 3 stars of this classic 7th game, Alex Burrows. Heroes are made on nights like tonight, and Alex was the hero. Roberto Luongo and Corey Crawford, two tremendous performances.